Good afternoon to all you awesome people. I welcome you all on our YouTube channel, JPSC Simplified. Let's crack JPSC. So my dear friends, in the previous three lectures, we have analyzed the pre and main syllabus of JPSC. We had a glance on the mains question papers also. We are left with the analysis of pre question papers, and that I will do in the coming lectures. But starting today, we are going to start art and culture series of Jharkhand. As you know, art and culture of Jharkhand in the prelims examination will consist of 5 questions of 2 marks each, that is around 10 questions will come from art and culture section of Jharkhand. The subsections here are folklore, 1 question, traditional art and folk dance, 1 question, folk song and instrument, 1 question, places, scenic, natural, archaeological, historical, religious, modern, 1 question, tribals of Jharkhand, 1 question. Here you can see that only 1 question will be asked from tribals, but if you see the extensiveness of the topic, it is huge. There are so many information that you have to remember. But my dear friends, the office that we are aspiring for is much more than just a medium to pay our bills. We have to bring these tribals into the mainstream. We have to work for their social, cultural, political and economic upliftment. And for that, we should be able to understand their social, economical, political and religious aspects. So we need to have in-depth knowledge of them as well as their customs. But don't worry, in this course, we will cover minute to minute details of the 32 tribes that are found in Jharkhand. So my dear friends, let's begin the art and culture section of Jharkhand. So today we will start with the religious places of Jharkhand. There are so many religious places in Jharkhand that it will be very difficult to cover all religious places in a single lecture. So we will divide this section into 2 lectures. Okay. So in the religious places of Jharkhand, the first religious place that we will look into is the Chinnamastika temple, which is also known as the Rajarappa temple. Okay. It is located here. You can see the image of the Rajarappa temple. It is located in the Ramgarh district of Jharkhand. It is located on the confluence of 2 rivers, that is Damodar and Bhairavi. Deity which is worshipped in this temple is goddess Kali. It is also called as the Vanadurga Mandir. It is one of the Shakti Peeth. Now you must be wondering that what is a Shakti Peeth. So my dear friends, Shakti Peeth, here you can read the story related to the Shakti Peeth, but in brief I will tell you, the Shakti Peeths were created on the earth where the body parts of the Sati fell. Okay, rest you can see that how Shakti Peeth came into existence. The whole story I have mentioned here, please go through that. Okay, so coming back to the Rajarappa temple, it consists of a main temple plus 10 other temples. The architecture style is Tantric style. You know, we have studied several styles of architecture of temples, like the Vesara style, the Nagara style, the Dravida style. So the architecture style of this temple is Tantric style. It has a headless deity, and this is the most unique feature of this temple, that the deity, here you can see in the picture, the deity is headless. Okay, entry and exit in this temple is from the east direction. In the right side you can see, in the right hand side you can see Dakini, and in the left hand side you can see Shakini. Okay, below you can see Kamdev and Rati in lotus bed. So these are the main important points that you have to keep in mind regarding the Chinmastika temple, which is located in the Ramgarh district of Jharkhand. So the second temple that we will cover is the Mahamaya temple. Okay, Mahamaya temple, it is located in Gumla district, Hapamuni village, Ghaghara block. Okay, construction was done by Nag dynasty ruler Gajakhand Rai. First priest of this temple was Dwij Harinath. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had chosen this way during his visit to Mathura from Jagannath Puri at about 1485 AD. So if it asks that which famous saint visited this temple, so you have to remember that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu once visited this temple, and the deity worshipped here is Kali. Okay, so this many information you have to remember about Mahamaya temple. The third temple is Ma Yogini temple, or it is also known as Gupt Yogini temple. It is located in Godda district, Pathargama block. This temple is located over Barakopa Pahadi, and this temple is said to be of the Dwapar period. It is also considered to be a Shakti Peet. Recently we have seen what is a Shakti Peet. Shakti Peet is that place where body parts of Sati fell. We have one Shakti Peet, we have seen the Rajarappa temple, and the second one we are seeing as the Ma Yogini temple or the Gupt Yogini temple. Its construction was done by Charushila Devi. It is believed that Pandav spent some of their time of their Agyatvas here. Okay, so this was all about your Ma Yogini temple. And the fourth temple is the Tapovan Mandir or the Tapovan temple. It is located in Deoghar. The deity worshipped here is Shiv. Okay, now the fifth temple is Ma Ugratara temple. It is located in Latihar district, Chandwa block. Deity worshipped here is Kali and Lakshmi at the same place, and that is the unique feature of this temple. Okay, that the idol of Kali and Lakshmi is worshipped at the same place. And one more important information that you should remember here, that 2 kilometers away in west, a mosque is located, and the name of that mosque is Majar Madarsa, constructed as Maratha Vijay Smarak by Rani Ahilyabai. Okay, so this temple was constructed as a Maratha Vijay Smarak by Rani Ahilyabai. So what is the name of the temple? Ma Ugratara temple, located in Latehar. See, mainly the questions will be asked related to the locations of the temple. They won't go very deep into the architecture of the temple. They may ask you that who has built the temple, but mainly the questions will be asked about the location of the temple. So first priority that you should allocate is to the location of the temple. The sixth temple is Sri Vansidhar temple. It is located in Gadhwa district. Okay, Vansidhar temple located in Gadhwa district. So Radha Krishna Mandir, Nagar Utari, fame is because of the golden idols which are worshipped here. So Radha Krishna's golden idols are located in this Vansidhar Mandir, which is located in Gadhwa district. Okay, the idol is made up of 32 mand of gold. So you should remember this, that the idol here is made up of 32 mand of gold. Famous for Baba Bansidhar and Raja Pahadi, this temple contains century old gold statue of Radha Krishna and Raja Pahadi, located at the top of a hill. This was constructed in 1885. Okay, so this many information you should remember about Vansidhar Mandir, which is located in Gadhwa district. The next temple is the Baidyanath temple. It is the most famous temple of Jharkhand, and I think every one of you know that Baidyanath temple is located in the Deoghar district. It is one of the 12 Jyotirling. It is also a very important fact that you should remember that it is one of the 12 Jyotirling. And now, what is Jyotirling? Jyotirling shrines are temples where Shiva appeared as a fiery column of light. So, this you can remember. See, reading the facts is one thing, but if you understand the concept, no, it is very easy to remember the facts. So, you should remember that it is one of the 12 Jyotirlings. And what is Jyotirling? Jyotirling shrines are temples where Shiva appeared as a fiery column of light. Construction was done by Gidhaur ruler Raja Puranmal, okay, in 1514 to 1515 AD. This question is also very important. I think it has been asked in some examination that who has constructed the who has constructed Badnath temple of Deoghar. So it was constructed by Gidhaur ruler Raja Puranmal in 1514-1515 AD. Akbar's Senapati Man Singh constructed the Mansarovar Lake here, and Chandrakant Mani between Ashtadal Kamal. Okay, it is said that a Chandrakant Mani is located here between Ashtadal Kamal. So the next temple we will go is Yugal Temple, which is located in Deoghar district. Here you can see the picture of Yugal Temple. This one is the Yugal Temple. Its other name is the Naulakha Temple. Now, why Naulakha Temple? Because when it was constructed, 9 lakh rupees were spent. So that's why the name Naulakha Temple. Construction was similar to Velur's Ramkrishna Temple. You know, in West Bengal, there is a Velur Math. So the construction of this temple, that Naulakha Temple, is similar to Velur's Ramkrishna Temple. It was constructed by Rani Charushila. The deity which is worshipped here is Radha and Krishna. Okay. Now, the next temple is Beni Sagar Temple, West Singhbhum District. Beni Sagar Temple located in West Singhbhum District. Construction 602 to 605 AD by Gund ruler Shashank. Deity which is worshipped here is Shiv, Durga, Ganesh. Okay, it is related to Hinduism as well as Buddhism and Jainism. The next temple which we will study is Jagannathpur Temple. So, Jagannath Temple, where the famous Rath Yatra is taken out, is located in Ranchi. But due to, I think today only, yes, today the date is 23rd June 2020, the date of Rath Yatra, but it is not being taken out in Ranchi due to COVID pandemic. Okay, but you should remember that Jagannathpur Temple is located in Ranchi. Construction was done in 1691 AD by Nag dynasty ruler Anesha, similar to Puri's Jagannath Temple. Okay, Rath Yatra also organized in the month of Asad month. This you should also remember that Rath Yatra is also organized in the month of Asad month. Okay, the height of this temple is 100 feet. Deity which is worshipped here are Jagannath, Balbhadra, Subhadra and Sudarshan Chakra. Okay, so as you know that in the Rath Yatra, there are 3 Raths. Okay, one belongs to Jagannath, one belongs to his brother Balbhadra and one to his sister Subhadra. So that you should also remember. Then the 11th temple is Kaleshwari Devi Temple. It is located in Chatra district over the Kolhua Hill, confluence of 3 Dharma. This temple is the confluence of 3 Dharma, that is Hinduism, Jainism and Buddhism. Deity worshipped here is Ma Kali. Here you can see the image. And King Virat's capital during Mahabharat period. So this place was King Virat's capital during the Mahabharat period. The next temple is Tanginath Temple. It is located in Gumla district, famous as Sivasthali and is famous for great Trishul of rust-proof iron, Tanginath. Okay, God Parshuram's Tapoisthal. So this place is known as God Parshuram's Tapoisthal. Okay, so you should remember this thing. So the next temple that we will study is Devdi Temple. Devdi Temple, it is located in Tamad in Ranchi. So Devdi Temple, I think most of you will know that this place is in news because our past Indian captain Mahendra Singh Dhoni used to visit this temple more often, and that's why this temple used to be in the news. So Goddess Durga has 16 hands. Normally Goddess Durga has 8 hands, but the idol which is located in this temple, it has 16 hands. Okay, in Devdi Temple. Devdi Temple is also believed to be the only temple where 6 tribal priests known as Pahans perform rituals and offer prayers alongside Brahmin priests who are mainly known as the Pandas. So one more unique feature of this temple is that out of the 7 days, 6 days tribal priests worship in this temple and 1 day prayers are done by the Brahmin priests who are known as the Pandas. An animal sacrifice by Pahan during Dashera is done in this temple. So I hope that you have understood about the Devdi temple, which is located in Tamad, Ranchi. Okay, so let's revise once the temples which we have studied. First of all, we have read about Chinnamastika temple. It is also known as the Rajarappa temple. It is located in Ramgarh district on the confluence of 2 rivers, Damodar and Bhairavi. Deity worshipped it goddess Kali. It is also known as Vandurga Mandir. It is one of the Shakti Peeth. And what is Shakti Peeth? I have mentioned you. Main temple plus 10 other temples are there. Tantric style of architecture, headless deity, entry and exit from east direction. In the right side, it is Dakini. In the left side, located is Shakini, and below the idol, Kamdev and Rati in lotus bed. The next temple we studied was Mahamaya temple. It is located in Gumla district. Construction was done by Nag dynasty ruler Gajakhand Rai. First priest was Dwij Harinath. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu visited this place. Deity is Kali. Third is Ma Yogini temple or the Gupt Yogini temple, located in Godda district, Pathargama block. Located over Barakopa Pahadi, Dwapar period temple. It is also considered to be one of the Shakti Peeth. Construction was done by Charushila Devi. Believed Pandav spent some time of their Agyatvas here in the Godda district. Fourth temple, it was the Tapovan temple, which is located in Devghar district. Deity worship is Shiva. Fifth, Ma Ugratara temple, located in Latihar district. Block Chandwa, Diti, Kali plus Lakshmi at the same place, which is the unique feature of this temple. 2 kilometers away in west, a mosque is located whose name is Majar Madarsa. It was constructed as Maratha Vijay Smarak by Rani Ahilyabai. Which temple? Ma Ugratara temple, located in Latihar district. Okay. The next temple was Sri Vansidhar temple, located in Gadhwa district. Radha Krishna Mandir is located here. Idol which is idol of 32 mand of gold is located here. This temple contains century old gold statue of Radha Krishna. Okay, I have told you that. Seventh one is the Badnath temple, very famous, located in Devghar district. It is one of the 12 Jyotirlinga constructed by Girdhar ruler Raja Puranmal in 1514 to 1515 AD. Akbar's Senapati Man Singh constructed Mansarovar Lake here. Chandrakant Mani is located in the Ashtadal Kamal. Okay, eighth mandir is Yugal Mandir, located in Devghar district. Other name of this temple is Naulakha temple because 9 lakh rupees were spent on its construction. It is constructed similar to Velu's Ramakrishna temple, constructed by Rani Charushila. Deity worshipped here is of Radha and Krishna. The next temple is Beni Sagar temple, located in the Western Singhbhum, constructed by Gond ruler Sashank during 602 to 605 AD. Deity worshipped here is Shiv, Durga and Ganesh. It is also a worship place of Buddha and Jain. Okay, the 10th temple was Jagannathpur temple located in Ranchi. Construction in 1691 by Nag dynasty ruler Anesha. Similar to Puri's Jagannath temple, Rath Yatra also organized in the month of Asad month. Okay, 100 feet height is there of this temple. Deity worshipped here are Jagannath, Balbhadra, Subhadra, Sudarshan Chakra. 11th is Kaleshwari Devi temple located in Chatra, located over Kalhua hill, confluence of three dharma, Hinduism, Jainism and Buddhism. Deity worshipped here is Ma Kali, King Virat's capital during Mahabharat period. The 12th one is the Tanginath temple located in Gumla district, famous as Sivisthali and is famous for the great Trishul of rust-proof iron, Tanginath, God Parshuram, Tapoisthal. Okay, so in this lecture, we have studied about the 12 religious places of Jharkhand. The next religious places we will cover in the next lecture. So, be with me in this journey. I hope that you like this lecture. So, if you like this lecture, please subscribe to my channel. Share this with your friends. We will meet again in the next lecture. Thank you.